class, how you doing? It's little Tommy coming at you with some retro Sunday blues on old Firebird. Hope you all doing good out there, man. I'm having a good weekend, nice and chill. The reason that backing track there was so deliciously out of tune is because I used two cheapo pawn shop guitars to do it. That I actually found in pawn shops over the years. Here's one, an old Hagstrom 12 string. And here's another one, an old Music Master bass that somebody chopped for a Gibson pickup. I think it's like a 71 or something. But yeah, bringing that up because, you know, yesterday was, it had an interesting thing happen yesterday. I've always loved, you know, crawling around in pawn shops. It's always been one of my favorite pastimes over the years, you know, going to music stores and pawn shops. If I ever get a day off, you know, just looking to see what's around. And over the years, I bought a few cool things, you know, found a couple cool guitars and stuff like that. But I had a day off yesterday and I was thinking I should go do that again, even though, you know, weird times in the world. But so I actually made a little trip out into the world and, you know, within CDC guidelines, I did a little pawn shop crawling, wearing my mask and everything. But man, I discovered something I just could not believe. All the pawn shops were just completely cleaned out. I mean, it looked like they were all so empty. Like, it looked like they were all moving or planning on moving. And I asked some of the guys that worked there, I said, "What's going on, man? Where's all the guitars and stuff?" And everybody was like, "Man, we sold everything. We can't keep anything in stock." And I said, "What? With the COVID going on and everything?" He goes, "Oh man, dude, people with the stimulus checks are coming in there and buying everything they had. There was like nothing left." Exactly the opposite of what I thought was going to be going on in there. It was really weird. Apparently pawn shops are doing like record business now in the midst of all this madness. Would you ever would have guessed that? Oy. You know, I wanted to tell you guys something. You know, that if you like that crazy reverb I was just playing through there, that's the old Ebo Customs rack spring tube reverb, man, that I'm absolutely in love with. I've gone off a few times before about those, but you know, the other day when I did a session, all I brought to the session was that, an old Les Paul and a Tweed Deluxe, and I was in tone heaven for two straight days, man. You guys gotta check these out. I mean, they are amazing. I mean, what they do to the front end of an amp is just incredible, like the tube preamp boost you get. Check it out. And you can make the verb, you know, super dark. Or you can make it super bright. Pretty cool, right? Anyway, we got some cool stuff in the old viewer comment bin. Viewer comment receptacle. Well, first of all, thanks for the kind words about the little instructional bit I put at the end of yesterday's video. Seemed like people got a lot out of that whole, like, notes on the neck thing, you know. You know, that is a huge part of playing guitar, you know. Beyond that, once you know your notes, you got to learn what to do with them, right? But you got to know where they are in the first place. That's step one, right? So work on that. And, you know, like one guy said, he said, "Hey, Tommy, can you show us beginners an exercise on how to learn the notes on the neck?" You know, like, this channel is open to everyone, right? I mean, no one is excluded, but I you could kind of tell that I've been aiming the content at sort of intermediate and beyond players, right? I really can't slow things down enough to like get into all that like real beginner stuff, but there's plenty of places you can go look for that stuff, you know. And then once you got it, come back and we'll get into all that. All right. A guy said, "Hey Tom, I'm from and in Cleveland. How do I get in the studios and show my skill? I can play and need guidance to get into the studios. Well, Matt, I responded to the guy. I just said, hey, buddy, I wish it was that easy, man. You know, it's like, I think, you know, step one is you gotta at least get somewhere where you could catch a little bit of the fairy dust that's falling out of the sky. I mean, I always tell my, you know, every summer we usually go out to Sun Valley, Idaho, and there's this old west like parade that happens every 4th of July that comes right through the town square, and all the people go and stand around. When the floats go by, they throw candy off the floats, and I always tell my little boys, you know, if you want to get some of that candy, you got to get up way up front. And you ain't going to catch any of that candy hanging around in the back. And that's just how it goes, man, with music. You got to go somewhere where there's some opportunities, you know, if you want to do something with music. I'm in no way trying to encourage even more people to move to Nashville. I'm not doing that, but I'm just saying there's plenty of places you can go where you have a better chance to, like, get something going on, you know, musically. I can guarantee you that I wouldn't have accomplished any of the stuff that I've done in my life if I would have stayed in Cleveland. No offense to Cleveland. I love Cleveland, you know, but I'm just saying, you got to go somewhere where the opportunities are. Step one, okay? That's step one. Okay, so another guy said, hey, Tom, I was watching this episode tonight and my wife came in and said, oh, I see you're watching your guitar man again. How does it feel to be my guitar man? It feels good, man. It feels real good. I appreciate that. A while back, Oz Noy contacted me and he said that he watches the show before he goes to bed at night. It calms him down. I don't know if he still does that, but if he does, just wanted to say good night, Oz. Hope, man, what a badass guitar player he is. Holy shit. Okay, we got a few more here. Let's see. Hey, Tommy, I'm your biggest fan. I need to order a shirt. I want to be part of the family. Well, if you're going to get one, you should get one of these. These are amazing. I love this shirt. I mean, I know it's not cool to wear your own merch. You rarely ever see pictures of John Lennon wearing a Beatles shirt, but I just like this shirt. It's super comfy. So, you know, those are available if you want one. You know, Drew, contact our old buddy Drew there. He can get you one. At Guitar House. Let's see, one more here. The guy said, Tom, I've noticed you tend to end your videos like my late father used to end visits to friends' houses. We'd all be having a blast, including him, and all of a sudden he's got his coat on, says a quick goodbye, and he's in the car. That cracked me up. That's damn funny right there. Yeah, you know, keep them wanting more, that's what I always say, you know? You don't want to hang around too long. That's a good lesson in life right there. That goes for anything. You know, always be the first one to leave. That's a good thing. Okay, so let's get into this loop that I was doing. Kind of a weird thing, right? It was like a lesson in sort of how a song could change meter and complete groove back and forth, you know? Started off with this, like, sort of... B minor, F sharp minor, C, G, with a little melody inside of it, right? Making a G6. some blues back and forth, D minor to A minor. All right, cats. Have a good weekend, rest of the weekend, and I will talk to you soon. Okay, bye-bye.